Ecclesiastes 9 and 13 says the following: "This wisdom have I seen also under the sun, and it seemed great unto me. There was a little city and a few men within it, and there came a great king against it, and besieged it, and built great bulwarks against it. Now there was found in it a poor wise man, and he by his wisdom delivered the city, yet no man remembered that same poor man. Then said I, wisdom is better than strength. Nevertheless, the poor man's wisdom is despised, and his words are not heard. The words of wise men are heard in quiet more than the cry of him that ruleth among fools. Wisdom is better than weapons of war, but one sinner destroyeth much good." Now, I'd like to go back and focus on Ecclesiastes 9 and 15. It says, "Now there was found in it a poor wise man." This lets me know, number one, that when it comes to wisdom, wisdom isn't determined by wealth or how much you have. A lot of people think that only rich people are wise, that, you know, you're a celebrity or professional athlete because those guys are so rich that they actually have wisdom when it comes to speaking about politics or things in life or something of that nature. But that's the world. Here in Scripture, the Scripture tells us that you can be wise and yet still be poor. Now, the world doesn't understand that, because the world says, well, if you're a wise person, how come you don't have your own business? How come you're not rich by using your wisdom? That's because maybe a poor wise man realizes that it is the Lord who sustains him from day to day, and that he doesn't need to make $1 million in order to survive from day to day, because he's wise enough to depend upon the Lord. So he's wise in spiritual things, but he doesn't necessarily need the material things in order to reflect that wisdom. So it is possible to be wise and yet be poor. Now, another thing that we can get out of this verse 15, it says that the wise man, it was by his wisdom that he delivered the city out of trouble. There's this little city in verse 14 where there were men in it, and a great king came against the city. But that city was saved by this poor wise man, according to verse 15. But it also says in verse 15, it said, yet no man remembered that same poor man who had saved the city. This is telling you right here that we live in a world that will use you up. So oftentimes people will use you for what they can get out of you. And once they've gotten what they want out of you, they don't care for you anymore. And here, the city didn't even, as far as we were able to tell, have a memorial for this poor wise man. They didn't name a street called Poor Wise Man Avenue or anything of that nature. They accepted the man's wisdom at that time in order for them to be saved from the king that was coming against them. But once the city was safe again, they forgot about the man. And that's what the world would do to you. You try to do something for the world may give you your 15 minutes of fame, but after that, it's all over and the world doesn't care about you anymore. So that's another important lesson to learn from this. Finally, we need to learn that wisdom is better than strength, and that people will oftentimes despise your wisdom, especially if the wisdom that you have is from the Word of God. So when it comes to this particular passage here out of the ninth chapter of Ecclesiastes, let's remember that wisdom is better to have the wisdom of God than it is to have anything else that the world can offer. Let us go to the Lord in prayer. Heavenly Father, Lord, we thank you for this short devotion, Father. Father, we learn here, Lord, that it is possible to be poor and yet be wise as far as your word and your scriptures are concerned, Lord. And so, Father, whether we are rich or whether we are poor, Father, we pray, Lord, that we can be wise by studying your word, by praying, by fasting, by having a closer walk with thee. It is in the name of Jesus we ask this prayer. Amen.